Is your bedroom just bursting with clutter?
Are you the maid of messiness or the king of collectibles?
Well, dust down your sorting skills and get ready to let it go. Hi, I'm Hannah.
And I'm Nigel.
And this is Clutter Nutters, the show where two kids go head-to-head to see who can reduce their bedroom bric-a-brac.
And this week, Luke and Alfie from Portsmouth will be taking on the challenge to try and slim down their rooms and lose as much mess as possible.
We'll start by slinging it all onto these super-strength Clutter Nutter scales.
Now, these scales can weigh up to 1,500 kilograms, which is about the same as a hippopotamus. Yeah, similar.
Oh, you're a bag of charm, you are.
Then they have to decide what they want to keep and what they're prepared to throw away.
And they get a chance to make some cash from their trash. And our hoarding little contestants will have to be brutal because the one who gets rid of the most clutter will be crowned this week's Clutter Nutter winner.
So let's meet them.
This week's opponents are best buddies Luke and Alfie from Portsmouth.
Hi, I'm Luke. I'm 10 and I'm a Clutter Nutter.
Hi, I'm Luke's dad and this is his room.
I only tidy my room when my dad nags me. I don't really tidy it properly because I just stuff it under my bed and into my wardrobe.
A lot of his cuddly toys now, because he doesn't play with them anymore. They just hang around, going mouldy and dirty.
I like my horrible jokes. I especially like to play those tricks on my mum. My dad says,
boy, how can you get it this messy in one day? Hey, boy! And I say to my dad,
well, Dad, I only tidied it up last week or last month or something like that.
So Luke's the class clown and his bedroom's jammed with jokes. He better get serious about losing clutter if he wants to win this competition. But what about best friend and opponent, Alfie?
Hi, I'm Alfie. I'm 10 years old and I'm a clutter nutter.
Hi, I'm Alfie's mum and this is his room.
I hardly ever tidy my room.
Actually, when he does tidy his room, he just chicks it all in a corner and that is tidy.
I like playing with swords and armour a lot because me and my brother always pretend we're like heroes from movies.
Apart from that, the rest of it is just collecting dust.
Clutter Crusader Alfie likes to pretend he's a swashbuckling hero. He's got a real battle on his hands if he wants to beat his way to that crown.
Class Clan Luke will have to transform from court jester to king of decluttering if he wants to win.
Don't forget, it's the one who sheds the most who wins the game.
I mean, I'm just scared to go into Luke's bedroom because he's such a practical joker. I'm just going to walk in through the door and I know a bucket of water is just going to fall on top of my head through my hairdo. I just don't want to be whoopee cushions.
Don't worry about it, Han. It's all good. I'll tell you what, you can go to Adventurous Alfie's room because it seems like you need a bit of toughening up. Let's go.
Oh, my goodness. What is wrong with this room?
Alfie, look at the state of your room. Do you play in here?
Only when it's tidy.
When is your room tidy? I've got a feeling never.
Show me some of the stuff you definitely don't want to lose.
Horrid practical jokes.
Dog do. What's the last one you got your mum with?
Whoopee cushion.
Was she amused?
No, not at all.
But you were, weren't you?
Yeah.
Luke won't be laughing if opponent Alfie beats him in the contest.
You got your camo bedroom, you got your walkie-talkies. It's pretty obvious you're into your army stuff, yeah?
Yeah.
On guard! Ooh, looks like I've got a fight on my hands to get Alfie to say goodbye to his swords and shields. You'll have to be brave, Alfie, if you want to win the competition.
Look at that cool caveman. I wonder if Luke's keeping it. What else has he got?
I've got my monkey.
OK, tell me about your monkey.
I call him Chocolate Face, because one time I went at my nan's.
Yeah.
He, my sister dipped his face in chocolate cereal. The good thing about it gave me a name.
There you go, gave you a name. Gave you a name for Good old chocolate face.
She's cute. She looks quite old. She's lost lots of stuffing.
She's very old.
Is she?
Yeah.
So she's part of your family, yeah?
Yeah.
Looks quite old
as well. My mum bought for me when I was about 1 or 2 or 3 years old.
Okay. So he's quite old. So this teddy is quite special to you?
Yeah.
Got your guitar here. Now, why would you want to keep a guitar that's in this state?
Well, my dad got it when he was younger, yeah. And he gave it to me and he said, what I'll do, when I get the money and when I've got the time, I'll put all the strings back on it.
Yeah?
Yeah, and and I'll take lessons.
When did your dad tell you this?
About 3 years ago.
About 3 years. We've been waiting 3 years for new strings, yeah?
Which things do you really want to keep in here?
Keep my teddies, my armour.
What about the stuff you definitely want to throw away?
There's some books and videos. I've got a CD player that I don't use anymore.
Excellent. Really weighty stuff like that is going to go. That's my boy.
OK, Alfie, are you in this to win?
Yeah.
Are you going to get rid of loads of clutter from your bedroom?
Definitely.
All right, put it there. Come on, like, fight like a man, not a girl.
So, class clown Luke won't be parted from his practical joke set, chocolate face the monkey, and his dad's old guitar. But he is happy to lose his books, videos, and CD player.
And adventurous Alfie will battle to the end to keep his swords and shields and teddies that mean so much to him. But can he live without his walkie-talkies and action figures? Well, they've cleared out their bedrooms, and the aim of the game is to split all of their stuff into two piles. Stuff they love and want to keep and want to put back into their bedroom, and the second pile, the lose-it pile, stuff they are happy and prepared to lose and never see again.
Now, how do we get rid of stuff from our lose-it piles? Not even our class clown, Luke, can make that stuff disappear.
So what Luke and Alfie are going to do are going to get all their good books and good toys and sell them on the streets of Portsmouth, and all of the money that they make will go to charity.
Then we're going to be recycling some of the stuff, and anything that gets left over will be given to our clutter compactor, Colin, who's basically a big dustbin.
Or you. He's a handsome junk-eating machine, Colin.
What are you talking? Can you smell that? Is that you?
Oi! Whoever smelt it dealt it. Right, before you guys get stuck into getting rid of your clutter, we need to weigh it on our scales.
Yes, we need to weigh it to find out exactly how much clutter we've taken out of your room, and I'm thinking there's quite a lot. Let's get it on the scales, Luke.
Let's see if Practical Joker Luke's bags of tricks are going to pump up the scales. Luke better start thinking about what he wants to keep and what he's happy to lose if he wants to win the competition.
So, Nigel, are you feeling confident you've got more than we've got?
I'm not worried about how much you've got and how much we've got. I'm worried about how much we're going to lose, Hannah.
Right. Look, I've got a little joke that I reckon we could play on Hannah. Make it look like I've put a nail through my finger. What do you reckon?
Yeah. Ow!
Ah! Nigel, what's
going on?
Oh, my goodness, what have you done?
It's all right, just his nail's gone through.
Do you want to take down to A&E now?
No, it's going to be all right, it's going to be all right. Ah, just leave it.
Okay. Oh, no, do you want to kiss? Oh, that is it. That is the last time I'm ever being nice to you.
Woo! We're up to 50 kilograms.
So his dad's guitar goes on, and there goes Luke's heavy CD player and the books he's happy to lose.
Ooh, if I were Luke, I'd keep that cuddly caveman.
Chocolate face the monkey adds to the start weight.
This is it, the big one.
145, get in there.
145 kilograms. That is a lot of clutter. I can tell you, it's about equivalent to the weight of an ostrich. I'll tell you what, though, we have to find out whether Alfie's got as much as that.
Yeah.
Alfie, what's it all about?
Wait. No, it's actually about how much clutter you get rid of.
Right, Alfie, it's our go. Let's put some muscle action into this and put some elbow grease into it. You ready?
Yeah, I'm up for it.
Let's chuck it into the scales, then. Are you going to get rid of that?
Yeah.
That's empty. It's got one little thing in it. So, adventurous Alfie, stuff
starts to pile on the scales. This clutter crusader had better be ready for battle if he wants to win.
Got my eyes on you. She's being a little bit too sneaky for my liking. A bit too sneaky.
35 kilograms. 42.
It's actually a huge improvement. So what about this little guy here? Do you reckon you'll keep him?
No.
No? You're gonna get rid of... You're gonna keep little piggy, though, aren't you? Little piggy trotters, yeah?
All out, these precious teddies add precious grams to the start weight.
Do you know what? I think this would look better, actually, that way on your face.
Oh, I think it's gonna be really close. We might even have exactly the same weight.
Ooh, might.
On goes Alfie's weaponry, and we're up to 143 kilograms. Now, this is getting seriously exciting because these guys have almost got the same amount of clutter and junk in their bedrooms. So let's put that up on the board. You started with 143 kilograms of clutter in your bedroom. I mean, that's not bad, is it?
That means Alfie's clutter weighs the same as an ostrich too.
Let the battle commence. Nigel. Thank you. On to me.
All the board games and battle gear from Alfie's bedroom weighs in at a ginormous 143 kilos.
But Luke's toys, jokes and tricks just tipped the scales at a hilarious starting weight of 145 kilograms.
So, it's even Stevens at this stage of the game, and there's everything to play for. Now it's time to love it.
Or lose it.
Right, boys, this is where the challenge begins. Because you now have to split all of your possessions into two piles. One pile with the stuff that you love and you never want to lose. Now, this is your love it pile. Anything left here will be going back into your bedroom, OK? But, of course, we want this pile to be as small as possible. That's if you guys want to win.
The other pile is your lose it pile. Now, this pile will be made up of things you have to be prepared to sell, recycle or compact.
Our clutter nutters have only got 10 minutes to make some really tough decisions about what they want to keep and what they're happy to lose forever. One, two, three.
And it begins.
Nice.
Losing the game.
Board game. Check out the speed, Nigel.
Luke seems to know exactly what's going on here.
Oh, out gone the glove.
I wonder if they're actually thinking about the fact that they may not actually ever see these toys ever again.
Once it's in your lose it pile, it can never go back into your love it pile, so think about it.
Yeah.
Looks like Chocolate Face is losing his best mate. Will he be next?
Now, what about your keyboard, which has got your dinner all over it, I can see, crusted on there. Love it or lose it?
Love it.
All right, so we're keeping that, we're keeping that. We're not doing too good on the checking out session.
Alfie looks worried. He's not so adventurous when it comes to letting things go.
I think another good tip here, boys, to remember is, when did you last see it? When did you last use it? When did you last think of it? If you can't answer any of them, then lose them, I reckon.
Why are you losing that?
Because, it's a bit young for you. My mum and dad said they're going to try and get me, like, a proper skateboard.
What was that?
I said I'm losing my CD player.
True to his word, Luke's heavy CD player goes on the lose it pile. That'll bring him one step closer to winning.
Nigel.
What?
I have to put this on by mistake.
Oh, no. You put it on the lose it pile and you want it on the love it pile.
Mate, I'm going to have to leave this on the lose it pile. Maybe you should take a little bit more time when you're bringing stuff over. Go on, mate.
It's quite hot now, isn't it?
It's a little bit hot. But maybe it's your tiger skin, you know.
Oh, what?
How long have you had him?
5 years.
5 years. Good mate?
No.
No? Gonna get rid of him?
Yeah.
Nice.
Luke's determined to win, and it looks like Chocolate Face is going to be swinging solo by the end of the show.
What are you gonna do with him?
I'm gonna keep him because it was one of my first ever teddies, and it helps me get to sleep easy at night.
So you're gonna keep him, you're gonna put him in the love it pile, yeah?
Yeah.
Right, come on, Alfie, I reckon we're nearly done here, aren't we?
Three, two, one.
We are all done.
But how are the piles looking? Luke keeps his dad's old guitar with the sentimental value. Looks like our Joker may be the King of Hearts.
After a tough start, Alfie has managed to lose a large amount of junk, and true to his word, our Clutter Crusader has saved his swords and his soft toys.
OK, finally, we have got our Lose It piles. We now have three choices for the things on these piles. Is that right, Nigel?
Yes. Firstly, we're going to be trying to sell some stuff. We're going to take you guys out, try and sell some of your good stuff, and then we're going to give the money to charity.
Secondly, we're going to be doing a little bit of recycling. I'm going to help you guys sort all of your bits and bobs out, and then you guys are going to hot-foot it down to the recycling centre.
Finally, if stuff does not get sold or recycled, we will be putting it into Colin, our clutter compactor.
Hang on, Nigel. He doesn't feel very well, Colin.
Well, I'm hoping he's going to feel a little bit better.
No, he's really under the weather. I just don't think he's going to be able to digest any junk food at all, honestly.
He has got a bit of a temperature.
Oh, Colin!
Jesus, dude. We've come down to Luke and Alfie's local shopping centre to try and sell some of their toys for charity. Now, if you want to do this, you need to get your mum or dad to apply to the local council for a street collecting permit. Once you've got this, you need to get permission from the charity that you're collecting for. Now, today, we are collecting for WizKids and the Rainbow Trust. Right, Luke, Alfie, we've come out here to try and see if we can get some donations for some of your old toys and stuff. So you're going to be collecting for the children's charity WizKids, Alfie. Okay. And Luke, you're going to be collecting for the children's charity, the Rainbow Trust. Now concentrate, try and do your items one at a time and get the best donation you can. Go on, good luck. See how well they do.
Would you like to have this toy and donate some money to charity?
I'll put some money in your box, but I don't need to keep your toy. There you go.
Thank you.
Alfie's getting lots of donations, but no one wants to take home his crazy baby toy. He needs to step up his selling technique if he really wants to make some money for his charity.
I think I should swap it for another one.
So Alfie changes tactics and tries to get ahead of the game by selling the England hat.
Would you like this England hat and donate some money to charity?
I think it's a wonderful England hat.
Is it all right for £1?
I think it's worth £1 easy. I think it's worth £2.
There you go.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Alfie's tactic pays off and he makes a cool £2 for his charity.
I'll give you £5 for it.
Yeah.
Is that okay?
Class Clown Luke's a born salesman. His monkey brings in a whopping £5 for his charity and he slides into the lead. The competition hots up and Luke pulls out all the stops to make the most dosh. This boy knows how to put the fun in funds.
Now I'm going to try and sell my goggly eyes. I'm
going to donate some money and...
OK.
Do you want to donate some money and get some free goggly eyes?
How much do you want to donate for my goggly eyes?
£2.
OK.
Another £2 for Luke's charity.
Do you want to buy a CD player?
Yeah.
Thank you. I just got £7 for a CD player. I think it was a really good sale.
Another £7. Luke isn't clowning around when it comes to making the most money.
I'm going to sell these bugs to someone so they can put more money in the charity bucket. Excuse me, do you like these bugs and donate some money to charity? 50p? Do?
Finally, Alfie makes another sale and another 50p to fill his bucket. But he's still lagging behind Luke.
Now I'm going to sell my caveman with the helmet haircut. Now I want to at least get £5 for him.
Do you want to donate money and get a free caveman?
Yeah.
The cuddly caveman's found a new home and Luke's made another £5 for charity. Result! But who's made the most?
Luke, how much did you make?
£34.50 and I'm feeling great.
And Alfie, how much did you make?
£24.95
and I'm feeling good.
£24.95
and you're feeling good?
Yep.
Both the lads have done really, really well. I'm proud of them both. We've made a bit of money and we're going to give that to charity, which has got to be great.
So Luke's come out as the top salesman, but there's time for Alfie to even the scores as our Clutter Nutters get recycling.
All right, lads, these Lose It piles are still looking fairly large, and by the end of the show, we need to have nothing on these. So, Hannah, I think it's time to get into a bit of recycling.
Now, you can pretty much recycle most things in your house, but before you do recycle it, you need to separate everything into categories, OK? So you can't mix glass and paper because it's just not going to work. So, for instance, if you've got a couple of games, you chuck them into there, or all your paper, all your old homework in there, toys that you don't want anymore into there.
Then you've got to separate your plastic, your electronics, and your metal.
Oh, and one other little tip. If you've got any toys or books that are in really, really good condition, pop those into a bag or a box and take them down to your charity shop. Don't give them to somebody like him, all right? Now, listen, you behave yourself and you get sorting.
OK, let's get a few items and start putting them into our respective recycle boxes. This is plastic, wouldn't you say? Definitely.
Some good bits of paper going in here, so once this gets recycled, who knows, it might end up as another book. You never know. It's funny, isn't it, to think that this little paperclip, once recycled, might end up being part of a really cool Formula One racing car. Bizarre, eh?
So, as Luke and Alfie race to recycle as much as they can, it's almost time to find out who's lost the most clutter and who has won the competition. While Luke may have sold the most clutter, in this round, it's Alfie who's the king of recycling.
You guys have done so well in sorting all of your clutter out, but now what you need to do is get it on down to the recycling bags, which you can find in pretty much most car parks and also supermarkets.
Right, guys, so let's grab a box and take it on down there.
Let's go.
Recycling your toys is a good idea because not only will it give you more space in your bedroom, it will help make the planet a healthier place.
OK, we have sold and we've recycled. Our Lose It piles are looking very small and they just contain the stuff we will be compacting.
Whoever gets rid of the most clutter is the winner. This pile, the Love It pile, will be weighed at the end of the show.
OK, this is it. Luke and Alfie have done really well. They've sold, they've recycled. All they've got is one or two items left on their Lose It pile. They are going to be compacted in Colin very soon. And very, very soon, we're going to have our big, big weigh-in to see who will be Clutter Nutter winner today.
Right, guys, do you want to bring your stuff over here, then? Nice. You know what, Nige?
Yeah?
I reckon Colin's looking a bit better. He's got just that little bit of colour coming through, hasn't he?
Yeah. Yeah, looks like he might be getting his appetite back. Get it all in there.
Don't forget, it's only the broken stuff that can't be sold or recycled that gets put into the compactor.
It's all in there.
I tell you what, I've never seen me that much.
Our Clutter Nutters have reduced their piles from this to this. And from this to this. Luke's kept his practical jokes and Chocolate Face the monkey.
And Alfie his battle gear and cuddly toys with the sentimental value. But who's going to be the winner?
Right, it's time to weigh your Love It piles to find out who has lost the most clutter, yeah? So should we go first? And then we're going to find out who the winner is.
Alfie's kept all the swords and shields he needs to reenact his next combat. But will he be triumphant in the final showdown?
Ooh, 17. A bit worrying, Alfie. Do you reckon it's going to be touch and go?
True to his word, Alfie's kept Sean the snowman. Oh, I hope he doesn't melt under the pressure of all those boxes.
Alfie, we're up to 45 kilograms already, and I'm a bit worried about this.
The last bits and bobs get scooped up and plonked on, and we're down to the final box for a final total of...
We've got 66 kilograms of clutter left in your bedroom, so let's put that up on the board. 66 kilograms of clutter. You have lost 77 kilograms of clutter from your bedroom. I'm feeling confident. That's pretty good, Alfie. How do you feel?
Happy.
We've done pretty good over here, guys.
Shall I tell you what we think of your 66 kilograms? Show them, Luke. Well, it's our turn to weigh in now, isn't it, Luke?
Yeah!
Let's find out who's going to win this one. Now, I've been meaning to ask you, why did you keep this?
She got it from my uncle when it on his wedding day.
Chocolate Face may have lost a few of his friends along the way, but he's definitely going to be swinging back into Luke's bedroom. Luke's dad's old guitar goes on, but has Luke lost enough to beat Alfie's 77 kilograms? Watch out, Mum, because Luke's practical joke set is coming home too.
23 kilograms.
So the final pieces go on. Who's going to win?
OK, Luke, this is the last bits and bobs to put on the scales and find out your weight. Go on, put it on. This is it.
Yes!
48 kilograms, 48 kilograms. Let's do a little bit of the maths now. So, you've got 48 kilograms left. OK, now minus that from the 145...
97. Nice!
You wish!
Little brain box there.
You've lost 97 kilograms from your bedroom. Alfie's lost 77 from his. That makes you the winner.
Yeah!
Yes! We've got a prize for you for losing the most clutter from your room, and it is a ticket for you and your family to go to a theme park.
Oh.
You happy with that?
So Class Clown Luke is king of decluttering, but our clutter losers are both winners as we've given their bedrooms a secret makeover.
You go and check out your surprise. I'll see you soon. Well done for clutter-nuttering and losing loads from your rooms. Now keep them tidy, would you?
Yeah, yeah, right, as if. Right, we'll see you later.
Alfie's room was like an obstacle course of junk, but now is a clutter-free base camp.
I have waved my magic wand, and this is what I've done.
Oh, wow. Really good.
Do you like it?
Yeah. Way cool.
How do you feel about it, anyway?
I feel excited.
When you're in your bed at night time, you can put all your teddies up there. So what do you think about your room, then?
I think it's better than I thought it would be.
Really?
Yeah.
Is that like a thumbs up?
Yeah.
Out of 10, how much would you give it?
I'm being honest with you, I gave it 10.
Would you?
Yeah.
Yes, I like it. Anyway, I think I'm going to leave little Action Alfie to his bedroom and I'm out of here.
Remember Luke's old room? It looked like an explosion in a joke shop, but now it's as exciting as a circus coming to town.
Oh. This is my bedroom.
This is your... Yeah, he doesn't even recognise it. This is your bedroom. So what do you reckon?
It's great.
Do you like it? And out of 10, how much do you like it?
10.
Do you? All right, let's do that. Nice. Well, you know what? I'm going to get out of here because I don't trust you. You're into your practical jokes and I've had enough of it all day. So I'm out of here. See you later.
Bye.